watching Pure Rock, and Pure Rock rocks my world, so keep watching. Thank you.
That was a good one.
There you have it. Go, baby.
Hi, this is Duff from Guns N' Roses, and you're watching Pure Rock.
You have a number one hit. So congratulations.
Thank you.
Has anything changed for you?
Well, as opposed to,
yeah, I could go out and go buy a bunch of toys.
And?
And I could eat whatever I want. Toys and food, it's a good thing.
As far as personally, there's been no difference, I don't think, in any of us. But, now we can do stuff we've never been able to do before, which is great, you know, when we have time to do it, you know. Before, like, we wouldn't have been able, if we were staying, we would both share a room, there would be two people in a room, and you couldn't order anything on room service because you didn't have any money, you know, you'd have to eat at the show or something. But now we each have our own room and you can order room service, so.
That's a good example. Okay, what's the reason for your success?
What is the reason? Timing. You know, we didn't time it. I mean, it wasn't like, okay, guys, let's get together here in 1985, and then, but, it was just, we were at the right time, the right place, you know. There wasn't very many honest bands.
How did the band form? I mean, how did you meet the other members?
Walking down the street.
Just?
I was walking down Sunset Boulevard. And just hanging out, walking down the street and said hi to somebody. And we started talking, had a couple cocktails and found out Izzy played. I met him and Axel was walking down the street. Slash I met in junior high school. I went to school with them. We were bad kids together. Troublemakers, super bad guys.
super
bad guys.
So let's play word association. So I say a word, so you each tell me the first word that comes into your head.
Pussy.
I say a word first. No.
What is it? First word came in my head.
Politics.
Politics. Shit.
Politics. Shit.
Bookers.
Army.
Navy.
Air Force.
Marines.
Top Gun. Harley Davidson.
Harley Davidson.
Davidson.
I don't have one.
Bikers.
Yeah.
Bikers.
Bobo.
Buddy Food.
Bobo. Bobo.
Bourbon. Jack Daniels.
Jack Daniels.
Of course.
Rupee.
Yes. That's. Next.
Nothing? Okay. The last one. Rocket Ball.
A way of life, babe.
Yeah.
So it's not that we're that great or anything, but at least, you know, at least we're realistic and we're sincere about what we do. And I think, you know, that and some other stuff that I have no idea why we've managed to get to where we're at. You know? It's not easy to. It's like because, I mean, we're like affected by shit the same way that most normal people are affected. And we don't like pose so that we can, you know, fit into the business or whatever. So it's like you don't get up in the morning depressed and put on a smile on your face and go out to the offices and start going through the bullshit. We like get up depressed and go to work depressed. And it's like, you know, or one way or the other, you know, if we're happy, we're happy. And it's, you know, that's just the way it is. So the album is sort of like very emotional, you know, and all the shit that we do is usually very emotional. If we have a really shitty crowd, we get, you know, affected by it, and we get pissed off. Sometimes we really insult crowds because it's like, all right, well, fuck you. You know, and so somehow I guess that works. I guess I mean, I don't think we'd be as popular in 1976 or 77 as we are now because there was more bands sort of like us. You know, So I think it would have been different, but we're the only band like us right now, so it's just timing and shit, you know? That's why you can't, like, try and pretend like you're bigger than life, because that's bullshit, you know? Okay, this one's my favorite out of the four. This is my favorite. Yeah, it's a good guitar, obviously. And then my next one is this one, because it sounds really good. It's new, and I had it refinished, and it's really cool. I used this for the whole Aerosmith tour before I got that one. This one is almost exactly like that one, and I use that one. If that one goes out, I use that one. If this one goes out, I use this one. If this one goes out, I use that one. See, oh, it's still low, but this looks cool, you know? So the girls don't see my winky. Let's see, for practicing, this is what I do. I mean, as far as I know, to me, this works pretty good. I don't do any scales, and you just try and, like, hear the first thing that comes to mind, or, you know, like, okay, say you're playing a, I don't know, how do I do this? You hear something in your head, and like I was telling you earlier, and apply it to the guitar as soon as possible. So, like, you try and sing melodies in your head. Now, I can't sing, so I'm not going to try and do it with my mouth. But, you know, it's like, I don't know how to explain it. You practice what you hear. If you don't hear anything, there's nothing to practice. So doing this, you know, it's like, fuck, you know, what for? You know, it's like Mary Had a Little Lamb or something. And then, but if, I mean, if it's like, you know what I mean? And you get it going, and that's what I practice. You know, that's the only thing I really practice, is just different kinds of melodies and stuff like that. So all I can say, as far as from my experience, is just to go for what you know and try and use whatever imagination you have to make up something, and then make sure that you don't miss a note and get it down.
ガンズ&ローゼスのスラッシュダフ、それにスティーズンのサイン入り色紙を1枚あげちゃう。リクエストも一緒に郵便番号107-06TBS ヤロックまで送ってちょうだい。2月11日の消印があるハガキまで受け付けてるからね。
All right, thank you very much, Nick.